There are around 2.78 billion people on Earth who uses WhatsApp. If I tell you that it only took 32 engineers to scale WhatsApp to handle 50 billion messages a day, you might think I am crazy. But the fact is, yes, 32 engineers scaled it like crazy. WhatsApp was able to support 50 billion messages a day from 450 million daily active users. WhatsApp was created to replace the expensive SMS, and it suddenly began to gain traction, 1 million people signing up daily. Imagine having a girlfriend who wants you to send messages every now and then. If you use SMS, paying around $5 for 100 messages, you would be broke and your girlfriend might break up with you. Thanks to WhatsApp, we don't have to worry about that. The engineering team at WhatsApp implemented several practices to meet the demand of extreme scalability, aiming to serve almost half the world's entire population. The very first practice they adopted was single responsibility principle. When WhatsApp was created, their focus was solely on creating one core thing, messaging. They didn't intend to create WhatsApp as an all-in-one app. They wanted to keep it as a simple messaging app. However, since Mark Zuckerberg bought WhatsApp, their idea has been deviated from just a messaging app to an entire social media application with payment functionality that no one will ever use. And communities, what the hell is that? Mark is trying to compete with Discord and Slack. Right now, WhatsApp is really a feature crap. Feature crap occurs when you add excessive features to a product and making it very difficult to use. We can confidently say that Mark has helped WhatsApp to reach a peak level of creep. The second most important thing that helped WhatsApp to scale was their choice of technology stack. They use Erlang to build the core functionalities of WhatsApp servers. Erlang is known for its ability to handle large number of concurrent connections and processes efficiently while consuming minimal system resources. This is really a pretty big deal for WhatsApp because they need to handle massive amount of messages and users. Another practice that WhatsApp team followed was trying not to reinvent the wheel. One of the core aspects of WhatsApp is real-time messaging. Instead of spending time on creating a completely new system, they used and customized Azure Bird, which is an open-source real-time messaging server written in Erlang. WhatsApp also utilized diagonal scaling to keep up the cost and operational complexity. Diagonal scaling is a hybrid of vertical as well as horizontal scaling. The computing resources were added both vertically and diagonally so that they can handle a considerable number of users. WhatsApp servers were running on the FreeBSD operating system. They also fine-tuned FreeBSD to accommodate 2 million plus connections per server. WhatsApp engineering implemented a continuous feedback cycle where they regularly measured the metrics like CPU usage, context switches, and system calls to identify and eliminate bottlenecks in their system. By continuously monitoring these metrics and making improvements at regular intervals, they experienced a compounding effect where each improvement led to further optimization, resulting in a significant improvement in WhatsApp's performance. They also conducted load testing to identify failures. Load testing is a process of measuring the performance of a system under an anticipated load. These were the technical things, but the main thing that helped WhatsApp to scale like this was the communication between the developers. As the number of developers increases, the number of communication paths also increases, not linearly but quadratically. And these were the main reasons why 32 engineers was able to build an app that is used by the entire world every day. So next time if you're building something, focus on the quality and not the quantity. And also consider subscribing to my channel because sometimes I really post some interesting videos. I see you in the next video.